is from Good morning, students. Welcome to the English class. Children, in today's session, we are going to do the last exercise of the chapter, that is helping verbs. So, today we will learn some rules for making the ing form of the verb. Okay? In my previous video, I have explained you the first rule of making the ing form of the verb. That is, to make the ing form of a verb, we usually add ing to the verb. Children, the first rule says that we usually add ing to the verb to make the word into ing form. Okay? So, the first example you can see I have written here, cry. Now, here the verb is cry. When we will add ing to the verb cry, the word will become crying. C-R-Y-I-N-G. So, here you can see we have just added ing to the verb. Understood? Now, let's see the second example. That is go. When we will add ing to the verb go, the word will become going. So, the spelling will be G-O-I-N-G. Going. Now, let's understand what the second rule says. For verbs that end in E, we remove the E and we add ing. The words which are ending with the word E, we have to remove the E and we have to add ing to the verb. Let's understand with some examples. Here you can see I have written here C-O-M-E, come. When we will add ing to the verb come, we will just remove the letter E and the word will become coming. So, the spelling of coming will be C-O-M-I-N-G, coming. The second example you can see here, I have written live. When we will add ing to the verb, that is live, we will just remove the letter E. As you can see, I have removed the letter E and the word will become living. Understood, children? Now, the third rule says that for verbs that end in L, we double the L and add ing. The words which are ending with L, we have to double the letter. That means we have to double the letter L and just add ing to the verb. Let's see with few examples. Here I have written travel. When we will add L and ing, as I have already explained you, the word is ending with L. So, here the rule says we have to double the L and we have to add ing. So, here you can see when L is added to travel and ing, the spelling will become traveling. T-R-A-V-E-L-L-I-N-G. So, here you can see we have doubled the letter L. Okay, now see the next example. Cancel. Now, here also you can see the word is ending with L. So, we have to double the letter L. So, the word will become cancelling. So, these are the three main rules to change to make the ing form of the verbs. I am repeating it once again. The first rule says that we usually add ing to the verb. Okay? So, cry will become crying. The second rule says when the word is ending with E, we have to remove the letter E and we have to just add ing. So, here you can see come will become coming. We have to drop the letter E and we have to add ing. Now, what the third rule says? The verbs which are ending with the letter L, we have to double the letter L and we have to okay, and then we have to add y and ing. So here you can see we have to remove the letter I and E, and we have to add y as well as ing. So the spelling will become L-Y-I-N-G, line. Same in the case with the next example also, die. In this case also we will drop the letter I and E both, and then we will add Y and ing. So the spelling will become dying. There is one more example, tie, T-I-E. When we will add ing to the verb tie, then the spelling will become T-Y-I-N-G. In this case also we have to drop the letter I and E both, and then we have to add Y and ing. So the spelling will become T-Y-I-N-G, tying. So children, remember these rules, as these rules will help you to make the ing form of the verbs. Okay, now please open your books. Today we will complete the last exercise of your book, that is question number D. So I will explain you the exercise and you have to complete it in your book with me only. Understood? Now let's see what this question says. Use correct helping verbs. Am, is, are, was, or her. Add the correct form of the main verbs given in the brackets to complete this sentences. Children, in these questions you have to use the correct helping verbs. Helping verbs I have already explained to you. There are, in this chapter we have learned is, am, are, was, were. There are many more helping verbs, but in this class we will study this only. Okay, so in these questions you have to use the correct helping verbs, and the main verbs which are given in the bracket you have to use the ing form also. Understood? Now, as I have already explained you the rules of am, is, are, was and were, so it will be very easy for you to do these questions. Okay, now first you have to read the sentence very carefully, understand it, and you have to understand that in which tense this sentence is given. Okay, we are talking about which time? We are talking about past or we are talking about present? Okay, so you have to understand it and then you have to do this. Now, the first question is, the students dash a test in a room upstairs. Now, here we are talking about many students. As you can see here, students means plural form is given. There are more than one. So, for more than one, as this sentence is in present tense. Okay, so in present tense, what helping verbs we use? Which helping verbs we use? We use am, is and are. So in this sentence we are talking about many students. So which helping verb will come? Yes, are will come. So here we will write are. So the helping verb is are. Now take will become, when we will add ing to the word take, it will become taking. But you have to concentrate on the spelling. As I have already explained you, in this rule, we have to drop the letter E and then we have to add ing. So, same in the case with take also, we will drop the letter E and then we will add ing. So, the sentence is, the students are taking a test in a room upstairs. Now, second sentence, it dash heavily now. Now here, now we are talking about present tense. Okay, now as I have already explained you which helping verb will come with the word it. Yes, we use is. Okay, so here we will use is because I have already explained you that we use helping verb is when we are talking about singular noun, that is he, she or it. So here you can see the word it is there. So we will use the helping verb is. Now when you will add ing to the main verb, rain will become raining. As in the first okay, when the noun is in plural form, we use are, and with the words like we, they and you, we use are. Now here, main verb is given, learn. When we will add ing to the word learn, the word will become learning. What will be the spelling of learning? L-E-R-N-I-N-G. Now this is the common rule, that is, to make the ing form of a verb, we usually add ing to the verb. Now the fourth question is, I dash on a picnic on Saturday. Again, we are talking about the present time, okay? I is talking right now, so this sentence is in present tense. So here, as I have already explained to you, the helping verb am. Children, am is always used with I, with pronoun I. So here you can see I is written. So helping verb will be am. And the main verb is go here. So when we will add ing to the word go, it will become going. So G-O-I-N-G. Again, the first rule will be applied here. To make the ing form of a verb, we usually add ing to the verb. Now, fifth one is, Neha dashed to her friend on the phone when I said goodbye to her. Now, here we are talking about past. Okay? So, in past, two helping verbs are used. That is, was and were. Okay, was is used with he, she, it and nouns which are singular in number. And were is used with you, we, they and the nouns which are plural in number. So here we are talking about only Neha. So Neha is singular. So which helping verb will come? Was. Because in this statement we are talking about past. Now talk will become talking. T-A-L-K-I-N-G. Talking. So the statement will be, Neha was talking to her friend on the phone when I said goodbye to her. Now the last sentence. Read it very carefully and understand. Last year, we dashed for the annual day at this time. Children, last year, we are talking about last year, the time which has already gone. So, this sentence is in past tense. So, here you can see, we is written. So, which helping verb will come? Yes, verb will come. Because here we are talking about many. As I have already explained you, the rule for verb, we use verb when pronouns like you, we, they and nouns in plural in number. Okay, so here we are talking about many. So, verb will come because we are talking about past. Now, rehearse. Rehearse will become rehearsal. Rehearsing. Sorry, rehearsing. So, spelling will be R-E-H-E-A-R-S. Then we will drop the letter E and we will add ing. So, rehearse will become rehearsing. So, the sentence will be, last year we were rehearsing for the